down towards the full forward position. Up high was McConville. A lovely mark taken over the top of the pack by McConville. You can see Sheedy and Walls having words about Sheedy's late tackle. Sheedy now having words back to Robert Walls and letting him know what he thinks of things.
Sheedy earned himself a reputation as a tough character in his 251 games with Richmond. And it's a reputation well-founded.
What about yourself? You were classed as the greatest headbutter in the business. Did you practice that, or how did you get it down to such perfection?
People at Essendon wouldn't remember those things unless guys like you bring them up. My players think that I was a reasonably good player and a very skilled
player. Well, you were a good player, but you still headbutted.
Yeah, look, I never ever practiced that as an art, to be quite honest, but... Gee, I'll have to think about that and set up a new training drill.
The one-time plumber has come a long way since the Tigers recruited him from the VFA club Paran in 1967. He took charge of the Bombers in 1981 and has gone on to coach the club to more than 300 games. This lunch was to honour his 300.
Good old Kevin on behalf of all of us. Okay.
And a new contract, did you hear that?
Now that's the side of Sheedy we don't see very often. The man's wit is as healthy as his appetite for the game. And let's face it, when you've coached some of the characters he has, you need a sense of humour.
Well, probably Michael Long is one of the funniest people I've ever met.
Yeah.
And I think Michael Long could be one of the best comedians that could ever end up in this country. He's got a wonderful sense of humour, doesn't speak very much, but absolutely makes everybody laugh in the club.
Can you give us an example of him?
Well, I mean, I suppose the best story I could ever tell was that I couldn't find Derek Kicker one night. It was that dark out there in the training track. I said, for God's sake, laugh as small as I can see you. And I was taking the mickey out of Derek because Mel Brown said, look, crack a few jokes. You're a bit serious lately, Kev. This is Malcolm.
Yeah.
So Michael Long heard that and he said that he sort of came over about 25 minutes later and said, look, I've got to go off. I said, Michael, you've been training really well. What do you have to go off for? He said, oh, got a leg injury. I said, well, what's wrong with them? He said, they're bruised. I mean, how could you ever pick a bruise on Michael Long? You know, so it's 6:30 at night in the winter. So he just looked at me straight pan, dead fan, you know, just,
yeah.
I got a bruise.
Now let's turn the clock back a few years at Windy Hill to the days of Paul Vanderhaar, the Flying Dutchman.
Hand pass, now he's got a shot for goal. What's the result? A goal! And he does a long kick up there towards Vanderhaar. Flying his cover.
Now, Vanders is one of my all